two missiles in just over 2 hours. North Korean leader Kim Jong-un appears to be in a hurry to perfect this technology. Both missiles presumed to be Musudans, according to South Korea's military, an intermediate missile with an estimated range of up to 4,000 kilometers or 2,500 miles, putting U.S. military bases on Guam within its sights. The first, a failure, says South Korea, flying 150 kilometers. The second flew 400 kilometers. The word failure has not been used for that one. Japan's defense ministry says both fell into the sea between Korea and Japan, one official saying they're seriously concerned at launches that could be considered progress.
Every time they're able to conduct a test, even when there's a failure, they can review the test, look at the data, and go back and correct those errors.
Swift condemnation from Washington, the State Department strongly condemning Pyongyang's actions, saying it will simply make international commitment to the current sanctions against them stronger. But so far, Kim Jong-un appears unaffected by sanctions or condemnation, even from its strongest ally and trading partner, China. In a recent interview, South Korea's defense minister told me in 18 years of former leader Kim Jong-il, there were 18 missile tests. In 4 years of Kim Jong-un, there have been 27.
You can develop a nuclear weapon and a device, and they've tested four times now, but unless you have some way of delivering it, it doesn't have any strategic value. So the missile program has to be seen not in its conventional light, but as a component of the nuclear, of the race to develop a nuclear capability.
And this is a nuclear capability that Kim Jong-un has made it abundantly clear he is going to continue to test and to improve. He also sees his country, North Korea, as a nuclear state, even if its neighbors and the United States will never acknowledge it as one. Becky?
What's been reaction around the world?
Well, certainly there seems to be increasing concern that the further this goes along, the expectation is there will be further missile tests. There is a fear of a fifth nuclear test. The chatter here in South Korea has lessened somewhat from within the government, but they had been saying in previous months they believe number five was just around the corner. They believe that Kim Jong-un is ready to carry out a fifth nuclear test. The physical preparations have been done. It's just when he decides the political time is right to carry that out. Of course, the expectation, or at least the hope now around the world, is that these sanctions will soon start to pinch. These groundbreaking sanctions, they've been described as unprecedented, that they will start to try and restrict some of the cash that's available for Kim Jong-un to carry out these tests and to improve his missile and nuclear program. But up until this point, it certainly seems as though he is carrying on regardless.